Hello, my name is Hentai Umi. I am a cyborg. Welcome to the Gizzverse podcast. The show dedicated to the King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard universe.
Yo, man, hot take. I honestly think that album is the best album that they've come out with.
We need more cookie.
A multi-dimensional universe with an invisible face.
Welcome to an altered future, brother.
Once created by a band, is now sustained by its fans.
Uh-oh. I hear the road train a-coming, baby. It's a-coming.
Open the door to your mind, fuzz. Here are your hosts, Tommy O'Neill and...
Hola, amigos.
Hello, world.
How are we doing, guys? Welcome back. I'm excited to be here. I don't know if you can tell.
I'm happy to be here, man.
Yeah.
You look excited, bro. Yes.
Yeah. This is where I live.
Those 29 ounces of coffee told me that you're excited and you're gonna get more excited here soon.
I've been drinking coffee since 2 days ago, and I've just been riding the train. I don't know why people like cocaine. You don't need it. Just need a lot of sugar. And a little more sugar, and then just put a little coffee on top of that sugar and just mix it really fast.
Yeah.
And this isn't milk. A lot of people think that I put milk in my coffee. It's not milk. It's just mostly sugar and then just a little bit of coffee, and I just mix it really hard.
Yeah, okay.
It's like a sludge. Oh, my God. I love it. It gets me going.
Delicious.
It keeps me up. Woo! I like.
The season,
do
buddy.
You like my decorations?
Tommy, I'm going to be honest with you, man. I'm loving your decorations. All in all, you are a decoration,
yeah.
You know? And I mean that like, truly the best way possible. Like, that is the holiday Gizmas spirit if I've ever seen it.
I saw a guy last night while I was at the cannabis store, Starbucks. Shout out. I'm going to get a sponsorship one way or the other. I'm figuring it out, all right? They give me free hats, free T-shirts. We're figuring it out one way or the other, all right? We got our sticker in there. They won't let me take a picture of it because you can't take pictures in the weed store. But, like,
ooh, interesting.
We got stickers up in there. Anyways, we're going to get sponsored by them one way or the other. We're going to figure it out. But one of the guys that was there, he had, like, little beard things all over his beard
ooh,
ornaments is what he called decorations,
yeah,
all over his beard.
Yeah.
I'm missing an opportunity. I can't grow a beard and I never will, so I thought about putting it in my hair, but that's just gonna look too goof. I can't do the hair thing, but yeah, I like to physically embody decoration, not just decorate. Just this is all I wear for the whole year, or for the rest of the year.
That's all
I'm wearing. Thanks, dude. I appreciate it. It really is all I need.
You should pierce your ears. You should pierce your ears. Get like little like boxes, you know?
Yeah.
Or if you don't want to commit, clip-on earrings would be great,
I'll
too.
I'll pierce my tongue, too. And just, you know, really really go all the way out. You know what I mean?
A little Rudolph.
Little Rudolphs.
On there. What do you think about that?
I'm good, dude. That's like the most painful and weirdest... I mean, no judgment. If you have it, good for you. That's awesome. But like personally, if I couldn't do it, I would never leave it alone. I'd freak out about my teeth the whole time. I would be touching it I would lose my mind if I had that. I couldn't, but maybe that's why you got it. Maybe you like that. That's like it. Yeah. Want something to play with in your mouth. You know, that could be a thing. This
to make that noise. You know?
Conversation went, to the South Pole pretty fast, in my opinion. You know what I'm saying, bro?
Let's bring it back up north then, daddy-o.
Welcome to the Gizzverse podcast, guys. We really appreciate you being here for the Giz holidays. And we're happy to be here with you guys, too. A lot of things to celebrate, a lot of things to talk about, a lot of things to get into. And I'm full of Gizmas joy, you know? Can I say that? Can
okay.
I say
Gizmas
joy?
Say it, dude. Yeah, dude, you are... filled to the brim with it, man. I love that shit.
I didn't have a chance to talk to you about your Thanksgiving yet. How was your Thanksgiving since the last time I talked to you?
Man, really nice time. Actually, did like first time ever. Emily's uncle was in town. Very nice guy from California. He was like, hey, why don't we just take everybody out to eat instead of doing the traditional thing? I was like, my man. So my Thanksgiving was about 2 hours long, and it was in a restaurant, and it was fantastic, dude. Didn't have to take anything. It was just great, man. Great all around.
Is that happening more, you think?
We can only hope. I mean, I love Thanksgiving. I'm just being an asshole. You know what I mean? But it was just so easy, dude. It was just the easiest Thanksgiving ever, you know? Like, pretty fun. Pretty fun.
And that surprises me because your family is... When I was a kid, my stepmom's family went buck for the holidays. Lots of people. Everyone went crazy. And I was like, man, this is a lot of people. And then I went to your family's house, and I was like, holy shit, this is a lot of fucking people.
We're here and to party.
Everyone was cool. Everyone's nice. But it's just a lot of people there to party, have a good time. So that's crazy that you go from that to going out when everybody kind of had their own signature dish that they brought to the table. Some, you know, people brought their,
not very true,
their signature macaroni and cheese, their signature banana, what was it? Banana cream pie pudding or something like that. It was banging though.
Banana pudding. Oh man, you know that.
It
goes.
Had like animal crackers in there or something like that. It was so good, bro. Man. Like, oh my god, god it was the best banana pie ever. Banana pudding. You could eat it however you want, whatever you want to call it. You know what I mean?
However you want to make it, buddy.
What is a pie? You know what I mean? What is a pie? So that surprises me. That you trust a restaurant to hold those type of. Was it more the cleanup?
Switch it up, buddy.
You just wanted to switch it up for the cleanup?
Listen, man, whatever Uncle Ed wants, Uncle Ed gets. You know what I mean? I can appreciate it. Okay, I can appreciate it, man. God bless his soul.
Well, I'm happy Uncle Ed came over for the holidays. That's nice.
You see?
Did your mom come along too, or she
She sure did. Okay, she sure did, man. And that was very nice. She had a lovely time too. You know? So, yeah, dude, the holidays are good, man. You know what I mean?
That's good.
But let me tell you something, dude. I got Gizmas on the mind.
Okay.
And you know what? And it's funny because it's still a similar mindset as the other last time we spoke about Gizzard, right? Like, it was like a Thanksgiving theme going on. We talked about what we're thankful for. And the end of the year just kind of does the same thing to me, though. You know what I mean? When you can kind of reminisce on it. And I've been kind of reminiscing on this year and like some of the goodies that they gave us. And, dude, damn you, Giz, you make the holiday special. You know what I mean? Will I be blasting it through the holiday season? I think I just might. I got into work the other day, and I was, you know, a couple minutes late. So what? No big deal. You know, we all have our issues. And my coworkers were bumping. I'm in your mind fuzz in there, and you know, felt pretty wholesome. And when I say bumping, I mean bumping. Are the speakers in there go buck? And they're also hooked up to the outside, so like the outside tables here too. And I was just like, I walked in. I was like, yo, what's going on here? Who put this on? Who put this on? And they're like, it's for you, buddy. You like it? I was like, I love it. He goes, they're so nice. That's very nice of you. You know, I said, like, listen, man, the Gizmas gives.
The Gizmas gives. If I was going to say something that I was grateful for in the Gizverse this year, I've turned quite a few heads in my group chats this year, and quite a few just comedians that I've come across that I've talked to, you know, they mention a band or have a t-shirt on. I'm like, yo, man, you ever heard of fucking the best band in the goddamn universe? And then I blast their ear with every... I've changed the ways that I've done that. I think I've talked about that on the
gotcha.
Podcast.
You got to evolve and, that, and, dude, yeah.
I had to evolve it because I was blasting people too much. And what I figured out is I go, what music do you like? And then from there, I recommend an album. And then that opens the door for them to go into the universe. So generally speaking, I can get to an equal playing field because King Gizzard's King Gizzard. Best band in the universe. Yeah. So like they will hit you in a spot at some point. And we've been doing this podcast for way too long for us to not be able to do that at this point. And I shouldn't be just 100%. Shitting in people's ears about King Gizzard. So I have been able to turn a lot of people's heads, and I am grateful for that ability. And maybe just like experience and wisdom on top of it. And, you know, I'm still excited about the band, but just not as like gung-ho where I'm like trying to smash people's brains into liking King Gizzard. And if they don't agree
dude,
with
you
me.
You haven't heard yet?
Dude, you don't right. think Nine Gun Infinity is the greatest thing you've ever... Yeah! It's like, all right, bro, calm
What's
down.
What's your problem?
Calm down. So, I agree, man. It's been a great Gizzy year. It's been all Giz all year round.
All year round.
It's the gift, so, it's the gift that keeps on gizzing.
It's the Giz that keeps on gifting. You betcha. So on that same subject of what you're saying, introducing new friends this year, let's go ahead and create a nuclear fusion and combine those two things.
If you meet somebody, fusion.
If you meet somebody willy-nilly, what do you, and again, I know what you just said, it depends like what the person listens to, this and that, but whatever.
Are you going to willy my nilly? As vague as possible.
If he's like, yo, dude, I'm here to willy your nilly. Goes, oh, well, check this out, Buster Brown. What record from this year would you recommend to a person the most?
Wow. Putting me on the spot.
I sure am, buddy.
See, like I said, that really depends on who they are. So you're going to have to give me a little more background on them. But I would say, man, I can't name the one. I can't name them all, like the name of the album, if that makes sense. Like, because I don't have it memorized like that. But
it's like Ice, Death, Lungs, Lava, Volcanoes, Lung, Gizzards.
Yes. Okay. So like
Trapezoids.
Probably my bananas. Personal favorite album that they put out, and it surprised me. And then maybe that's why I enjoyed it so much. It's zero hype. In terms of, like, I wasn't listening to anything on purpose because we were gearing up for the Red Rocks show. So I was, like, putting King Gizzard away for new stuff. And I'm like, they're going to play that. Right. So, like, fuck it. And then, like, they were dropping that right before the show. And I was like, all right, I got to give it a listen for the podcast. And then I was like, dude. Every song on that album is a banger. This is why I hesitated saying this at first. So, like, I don't know that it's for everybody. But it's for me. It's definitely for a King Gizzard fan. It hits all my shit. It felt like Polygon in a lot of ways, and that's because they were talking about the planet and stuff like that. I thought it immediately when I heard the album. I was like, hell yeah, we doing it, dog. We doing it. And that's my if you listen to the podcast, and if you do listen, that's another thing we're really grateful for. You guys subscribing, you guys liking, all that's, it really helps us out. And that, it in and of itself, we've noticed it this year. You guys have doubled down, boosted up. You came over with us to another platform, and it helped us immensely. And we're going to talk about the meetup in a second, because that's got to be his own little thing. But, like, you guys helping us out, we've noticed it. We appreciate it. We try to mention it as much as we can, but, like, Merry Christmas, guys. Merry Gizmas. That's very awesome for you guys to be consistent and very cool about that kind of stuff. So let me ask you, Brian.
Very damn cool.
That's my answer for the album. And I think a lot of people are going to say Iron Lungs, right? That's the name of the album. Or that's the name of the song, rather. Lungs?
I mean, Iron Lung, I think, is the most
Iron Lung.
I don't want to say palatable.
I couldn't remember if it was Iron Lungs or Iron Lung.
Just one. Yeah, just one just single one. Lung. Maybe my favorite song of that album. Yeah.
So that's the song that when I was talking to folks, that's the song. Maybe it was just because it just came out, but like people were like, fuck yeah. And I was like, I totally agreed with them. So again, that's the album that I would, what album would you say for you, would you recommend for somebody out of this whole, just this year? We can't go back any further, just this year.
No, yeah, for sure. Let's see. So I really just thought of that question kind of on the spot. So then I was thinking of my answer while speaking to you.
No, it was a good move. It was a good move. I usually do that to you, and you fucking got me with it this time. You sniped me with a question. You put me on the spot, and I genuinely had to think about it for a moment, but got me, bro.
Let's see here. I'm almost between two. I mean, your choice is on point. That's a killer record. It's one of my favorites of the year. Joe Guy, I might not recommend to. Again, depends what homie likes. And if you like prog rock, if you like anything kind of fun, trippy, I agree. That record tickles my fancy so hard. Just like visually, like the album cover and stuff looks so damn cool.
Yo.
The vinyl records I bought, one's like pink. It's supposed to be like a lung. It's supposed to look like a nasty lung. It looks awesome, dude. Like, it's so cool.
The music videos.
So I can appreciate it. The video, insane, dude. Yes. Groovy stuff. All that being said, I'm probably recommending changes to somebody.
Ooh-wee.
It's I could say now a little removed, it's my favorite album of this year from them for sure. Not too many songs are super long, which that throws some people off. I don't mind it at all. So like I feel like, I mean, Emily's had it on repeat for like 3 weeks, it seems like. Huh. She's just been like lost in like a loop of it. And it's just a lot of killer tracks. It feels, and it bugs me. I don't know if I've said this on the podcast already, so sorry if I'm being redundant, but it bugs me a little bit that that's my favorite album of 2022, because a lot of it was made in 2017. So I often wonder, is like, have we seen the best Giz? Is there better Giz coming in the future? And like, the fact that that's my favorite record of the year is kind of like, I just love that fucking old school shit, you know?
Okay, so I, as I always do, I have to relate this to myself and being a comedian. I know, guys, that's a problem. It's narcissism. I'm seeing somebody about it. My wife hates me already. I don't need you to hate me too. Okay, stop it.
Don't do that.
There are times where I write stuff that I'm like, I'll try it a few times and it's not working right, not pacing right, not feeling it, doesn't happen. And then I'll pick it up a year or two later, 3 years, 4 years, and I'm like, dude, you didn't see this before? A plus B equals C, dumbass. And then I'll see the path a lot clearer. That could easily have been something that they went through where they just jammed a little bit, recorded it, and were like, I don't know. I don't really like it that much. Or maybe they got more excited about something else, so they put it down and then picked it up later. That's perfectly fine. That's perfectly fine. And I think that's how how we're able to get so much diversity from the band, because they're playing from almost like different times in them. So within them, they're playing at different. It's like going through a time portal. You know what I mean? It's cool, man. That part excites me. Don't worry too much about that. Don't worry too much about that. I think we're okay in that department. I don't think we've seen the best of them. This is why I don't think we've seen the best of them. It's because the last time we saw them live, the best musicianship I've ever seen out of every single one of them individually. I knew it was possible. I knew where they could be at, and I you could see hints of it. But they still have to make a song at the end of the day. They still have to make a palatable thing to give you to play in your car, to play on the radio, to play on Jimmy Fallon, to play on whatever. So they can't be up there and they finally have just gotten into that world where now their musicianship is up. I don't even know if that's a word, and if it isn't, I'm sorry. I'm not trying to sound pompous. That's just the word that my brain is trying to say. But their skill level is fucking crazy right now because they've just been playing. Now they have this like experience, wealth of knowledge of their own discography that they can just bounce in and out, in and out, in and out, in and out. And I confidently believe that we are just seeing the future of this band. 100%.
I don't disagree with that at all, man. I think it was pretty well put. And I totally agree with you on the like revisiting stuff. Cause then you're like, you look at it a little sideways one day. You're like, bro, that's a layup. Why haven't I been sitting on that for 4 years, you know? And also the answer to, they wanted to drop this in 2017. The answer to this was Polygon Wannaland. So like if you have that floating around in your mind also, like easy to be like, oh man, well, let's like finish up. I got this Crumbling Castle thing going on right now. Let's rock that out real quick. So I totally get it, dude, for sure. That's fucking tight. Stu said in an interview that, or no, was this, I think it was the KEXP, which is an interview, so the newest one. He was saying that they have like 100 songs in rotation right now, and they, you know, that they play. There's some songs that they're not gonna play live, and it's just probably not gonna happen anytime soon.
My God!
But they have 100 in rotation of like boom, boom, boom. Well, we haven't played that one since. And Stu literally tracks this stuff like on an app. So be like, well, we actually haven't played this since September 14th. So we should pepper this one in because we haven't played it. So statistically, that's one we should play. And they're like, yeah, cool, Stu, for sure, man. We'll play that one that we like forgot existed for a little bit. So it's cool, man. Yes, their musicianship is only getting cranked.
I'm not sure if Stu would like me. You know what I mean? I'm a lot. Too much Tommy. Somebody told me that. Well, I'll never forget it. It was like the biggest insult, and I'll never forget it for the rest of my life. Because like that's now how I make money is being too much of myself. So, but that phrase has always stuck with me. I fucking hate that phrase. Too much Tommy. You're too much. It's like, fuck you, bro. What the fuck are you? Anyways, I know I'm a lot to handle, but like every time I find a nugget out about this motherfucker makes me like him more. I like that shit. I like
hell yeah.
Stats, numbers, putting stuff down, writing it, being extensive, like put everything accessible. Don't just have like a planner full of garbage. Like, no, dude. Organize that shit. That's your job.
Facts. Like, yeah, we got
it. I love that shit. Dude, that feeling of being organized, prepared, and then having your arsenal behind you is so... I love that feeling. So I'm clearly... There's another side to this that isn't just...
Oh, yeah, dude.
We're up there just fucking jamming, dog. You know, that ain't it.
Mm.
That ain't it. These guys are... It's like... I don't know if it was the last podcast or the one before this. This shit is a lot smarter than I think people give them credit for. They're more calculated. They're a lot... And now they're getting to the place where they have family. So, like, what is time worth? What is money worth? How much money are we making? How can we make money like this? And all that. It's all calculated.
Interesting thought process, huh?
Yeah. They've gotten past the point of, we're just going to take anything and everything we get. Gimme, gimme, gimme. And every artist goes through that stage. But if you can penetrate through the other part where you're controlling the environment, I mean, dude, it's very calculated. And it's good to see that it's meticulous. They're clearly learning the mistakes of people before them and all that stuff.
Yeah.
And I just really want
to... They have so much to reflect on, man. Yeah, it's cool. It's inspiring, man. It's like I've never seen the like robot type effort from a band that I really admire this hard. I'm not saying like, dude, no. Bands, especially back in the day, bands toured, yeah. My man. Like they didn't, their family dynamics were horrible because they toured so hard. So like you just said, Gizzard, every band and every experience, we have so much to look back on and be like, well, they were amazing, but that might have fucked them up. They did this, that might have fucked them up. How do we avoid those things? And also like the music has not, I mean, you listen like Ice Death. I was comparing the other day. I was like, man, our buddy Brent asked me, he texted me randomly, he's like, yo, what are your three favorite Gizzard albums?
Ah.
Here we go, man. And I said, Mind Fuzz, Nonagon, Float Along, Fill Your Lungs. And listening to Mind Fuzz, it takes me somewhere. You know how it goes, bro.
God.
Mind Fuzz takes me to a different place. I told Brent, I was like, Mind Fuzz just takes me to, it reminds me how grateful I am for my youth. Always, dude. And it's funny, I told him I feel 16 when I hear it. We were 20 something when we first heard that song, but it feels, it's just like your youth, bro. I'll always treasure that record.
And I think that there's keep what you're going to say, like keep it in your mind. I think there's an element to this of us becoming 30 and going on to the next stage in our lives. And we just happened to come on to King Gizzard as we were in our like mid 20s. And like, that's in that. It was emblematic in some kind of way, and I totally fucking understand. Agreed. What you're talking about. And I don't know if you have to be kind of in that age range. I don't know, whatever, but like I totally understand what you're talking about when you said that. And I think it was really poignant. Sorry, go ahead.
Heard. Yeah, I thought you would. I'm glad you did. So like listening to Mind Fuzz, I was like, God damn. It was after my coworkers played at work. I listened to it because I had it like in my head. There's certain Gizzard I tried. You know how it goes, especially that one. There's certain Gizzard I personally try to like save away so I don't blow it out of its ass. I've heard it so much. And that's one of them. I just treasure it so hard, dude, you know?
Yeah.
But like you listen to that compared to like Ice Death and stuff. It's like the progression they have as a band has been so cool to watch. And the music's not like, oh man, they're just out there just doing whatever, just throwing something against the wall. No, it's like killer stuff, bro. It's like, it's just progressing. It's like really cool to watch. And like, while I always have a super soft spot for that older stuff, always, I'm just so excited to see what they're going to pump up all the time, dude. It just seems so fun, man.
So maybe I'm wrong here, but for me personally, I think as a fan, I could be better at not digesting them like a comic book. Or a book, whatever you want to call it, where like I'm taking the album or taking the year as like a series of a novel. Like I'm just like digesting it and being like, all right, that was cool, man. Where's that next one, dog?
For sure. Peaks, I get that.
The problem is, and you kind of rubbed up against this, the problem is listening to the album too much when it comes out, like a lot. Too much, way too much when it comes out, which is a problem when you're trying to review it and trying to go over it. And there's still albums that we even haven't reviewed because of how much stuff they have and genuinely putting effort into their reviews. We've talked about this, put together reviews and just not been able to do it. We've recorded reviews that have not gone out. And it's because it feels weird or disingenuous and not full of information. We're just like going down, reading the list, and they put out a lot of shit.
Oh, this one,
They put out a lot of shit, and it's hard to keep up as a fan base. So it's dual-sided. They're putting it out. So, like, we are digesting it as they put it out. But what you just said is, I think, on target, which is to go back and look at all the stuff. It's like, wow. Wow, wow, wow. And
nuts.
It is nuts. And you have to pay homage to those, I think, original albums that set up the foundation. They wrote the original magic that the world exists on today, that the Gizzverse exists on today, if that makes sense. If you guys know what I'm talking about, you know what I'm talking about. But like, they set those Mindfuzz and Nonagon especially, they set the foundation to which we are standing on today, for sure.
I think so. I know that's like a
controversial statement.
Some people will take that. Not, I can't see controversial. Some people will take that in a certain way.
Right.
Whatever.
And I don't mean it. It does. And I don't mean it in a certain way. And I'm glad you said it, because I was definitely going to have to mention it too. I know oddments. Okay. I know there's albums that came out before this. And I know they were if you listen to those albums, you have to be genuine. They were figuring themselves out. And then Mindfuzz came out. And it was like, what the fuck is this? And then Nonagon came out. And it was like, yo, this might be the best rock album that's come out in the last 20 years. Dead serious. No,
Nonagon's crazy.
No hesitation saying that. You have to record. I say that to people, and the arguments that they give me are like, bro, what about Everclear? They're fucking like the dumbest shit I've ever heard in my entire life. Like, that's the examples you can give me in the last 20 years. Like, bro, fucking, dude, there's a lot of rock bands. It's like, okay, man. All right, you put that list together and you get back to me. We'll put it up against this album. And we'll listen to it. We'll listen to it together. And it ain't going to happen, Jack. Nonagon and Mindfuzz set the magic. I forget the phrase. It's from Narnia. Aslan says it to the witch. He says, don't quote the dark magic to me, witch. I was there when it was written. And, like, that's Nonagon. I should make that meme, dude. That's Nonagon in Mindfuzz. It's
that's
like,
fire.
Don't talk to me about shit, bro. Like, I was there when the dark magic was written, bitch. And that is how I feel about those two albums, 100%. Like, everything we stand on is because of that. So there's a reason that we still hear Nonagon. There's a reason that you've seen him a thousand times.
There's a reason it closed out night two at Red Rocks for a reason, dude.
There's a reason we hear Mindfuzz. There's a reason we still hear Banana. They tie it into albums. There's a reason, dude. They are paying homage to the Giz gods. Oh my god, dude. I did not write any of this. This is totally off the fucking dome. Like, I've never thought of this before, but it is so dead on point. Like, they are literally paying homage to the Giz gods because they know the dark magic that they lie on. And this is it. This is it. The Nonagon Infinity opened the fucking door, bro. They had to get in your mind, Fuzz, to find the Nonagon, open it up, and boom, bro. Here we are. I have chills. I have chills all the fuck over me, bro. Like, those are the two most important albums in the Kiss universe. I don't even know how we got out of this conversation, but like...
But it needed to be said, goddammit!
It needed to be said, bro. I think you nailed it. It absolutely... I couldn't agree more with you. And that third album... That goes to taste. That goes to whatever you think taste is.
Yes,
you
know what I mean? I agree with that 1,000,000%. Yeah. Yes.
Oop, Brian went dark on us for a little bit. That's okay.
Some jerk's calling me.
He's answering.
Like, what could you want right now?
He's answering some kind of weird drug deal, probably. If I know Brian, it's got to do with records, shoes, or drugs. And kids, I don't recommend that you get involved in any of these things. He just got off the podcast. I don't even know what happened to him. Oh boy. Oh, this is a perfect opportunity to talk about the things that are sitting over me right now. These little coaster guys. I'm actually they might look so good that they look like they're lasered onto these pieces of wood. But I actually made these little King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard coasters for your bar or your kitchen or your living room or whatever. And these are all burnt on by hand. I created the stencil, did it all by hand. These are pieces of branches from the tree in my backyard. I didn't hurt the tree. Don't worry. I didn't cut it down. But there were branches that needed to get cut down because they were going into my neighbor's yard. And I was afraid, like, oh, my God, I'm going to have to pay for something if it falls down on something. So, like, we're actually going to put these in the Gizzverse podcast store. And we're going to make these available for pre-order soon. So, don't worry. We're going to launch a little campaign on them. And you guys will see. What we got in store for you, because I know we got that T-shirt coming out too. So,
good, Daddy.
I just figured while Brian was getting his phone back on, we'll talk about that. All right, I gotta zoom back out now. Hold on, let me find you, Brian. Hey, did you get everything handled?
Zoom, Daddy-o.
Is it okay?
Hey, buddy.
Hey, buddy. How's it going, man? I missed you, man.
I'm doing good, man. I'm doing good.
Was it a scammer?
I'm pissed. We were balls deep in passion. We were balls deep in passion, dude.
I know. I'll edit around it, but I'll use that coaster commercial as a way to get around it. But I will say, you are looking to get your loved one a Gizzverse podcast merchandise in any way, shape, or form, we got plenty of stuff on the Instagram. I think we are going to start moving into the Etsy store world. We were advised to do that by some of the other people in the Gizzverse. They were surprised when we didn't have one. Like, what's up? What, dude? So, like, we got to get one. And stop being losers. And then, yeah. And the coasters are moving there. But the Instagram, I would say, is the best way to do it. And low-key, just between you and me, if you follow and subscribe and listen to the podcast, deals will come your way that will not be available to anybody else but you. Keep that on a hush-hush. Could have some key words or something like that, or whatever you want to call it, but you're going to have to listen to the show to get it.
Exclusivo!
Or you guys will be dirty and just give that password away to anybody, and then we're screwed!
You wouldn't dare!
And then we're screwed! No, that's fine. If it's all listeners, then that's that, and then we're grateful for you. So yeah. Anyways, I forgot what we were talking about, Brian, but let me ask you something.
You mentioned the two, you know what? The two most important albums in the Gizzverse.
Oh, and the third.
Agreed. Nonagon, Mindfuzz. And third, all preference. Yes.
The third is all preference. I think the third is you're allowed a preference point at that. But the first two, you have to be honest. You got to be dead. You can't just say, like, this isn't. It's like when people come in there and they're like, oh, yeah, LeBron James, he's the best basketball player. It's like, you can't just say that. You can't just say that. You have to say who built that world, who built the ground that they walk on today. Like, it's facts. I'm not saying whatever. I don't want to get lost in a conversation, but, like, you have to pay homage to the – and I think King Gizzard pays homage to the Giz gods. Every show, and they do it correctly. They know what they're doing, and there's a reason that they tap onto those albums. It's not a coincidence. They don't play Crumbling Castle every night. They don't play Murder of the Universe every night. They actually might. They actually might play some Murder of the Universe every night, because there's a lot of diversity in that album, and there's a lot of stuff you could tap on.
Because so
if you're playing Nonagon stuff, well, here's Lord of Lightning sitting over here. Balrog, I think, is an easy song to tap into, period. You could just get into that. That's a rocker. But they have...
Sorry. Our very good buddy Brent, I asked him, he asked me my three, I told him mine, and then...
Brent was a double shout out. Hold on, give me the noise. Bam, 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 bam! Brent, double shout out. Brent brings all the girls to the yard. Brent's like, my better than yours. Brent's like, my better than yours.
It's better than yours.
Yeah!
He's a little later into the Gizzverse, so I was very curious to know what his three would be at this point. You know what I mean?
Whoa. What did you say? You kind of cut out on my earpiece. You said he came a little later to the Gizzverse?
Gizzverse, correct. Okay. You know? He's probably listening. I mean, I'm just throwing this out there willy-nilly. Maybe like 2-3 years, perhaps, of like this last couple years, like trying to like dig, you know? And his number one, I was like, whoa, Nonagon Infinity. I was like,
you know it, dog.
Damn, man. You were a real one, bro. And he's like, bro. Evil Death Roll.
He also listens to the podcast. Train. So he's an old head, you know what I mean? Because he listens to the podcast. He like
hip to the vibe.
You could catch up. If you listen to this podcast and you're feeling like, I'm lost, no problem. Start at the front, work your way to the back, baby, because we good. That's the way to do it. And we've had a lot of people message us, because like they'll message us and they'll be like, hey, man, episode 22, the audio is messed up. Can you go back and fix it? So like that, we know that that happens, and it's really nice that people do that. Fuck yeah. But like Brett, he listens to the show, so he's an old head, bro. Let's be real.
Not a gone good start. His number two, I was like, whoa. But that's also what kind of kicked him off to was Invest the Rat's Nest.
Hey, so he likes that.
I was heard that.
And that's,
yeah, so, I was like, interesting, yeah.
And what's interesting about this is because we talked about that podcast. I'm not even exaggerating. We talked about this is going to bring in a whole batch of new fans. A whole other.
Yeah, and that happened.
It did happen. And we talked about it again, I think, in the Red Rocks podcast, but like. There's a reason why I'm referring to them as Rat's Nest fans, because I can tell what album you came in on, what album you started your little journey on, and what albums you listened to. And it's easy to see which, you know, people are singing along to certain songs and jamming out. This isn't a criticism. My wife says that everything that I say sounds like a criticism, that you could take this as a criticism. It's 100% not. If you listen to the show, you know it's really more admiration and love for King Gizzard that they're able to do that, because like that's a feat. When you go to a Slipknot show, you're going to a Slipknot show. Like everybody's a Slipknot fan, and that's the genre of music you fuck with, you know? When you go to a Giz show, some diversity up in that mug, dude. Some diversity.
For sure.
And I mean, I'm not dressed the way that everybody else is dressed. You know, I flat shirt, hoodie, jacket. That's what I'm wearing. I don't wear funky shit, bro. Like I stopped at middle school. And everybody's wearing whatever they wear. Whatever they, you know, and some people are putting on like a show. Some people put on like outfits for the show. You know, they want to be like a part of the whole thing, and it's fucking, that makes it a whole other element. I've never seen anything like that. Ever. And I'm sure people have. You go to a Flaming Lips show and it's like that. And I've never been to a Flaming Lips show, so maybe you could say that.
Do it,
like that.
Dude.
But yeah, I know.
Do yourself a solid.
Hey, man, if they come to town and they're here, if they're at Red Rocks, I'm going to see them. So, like, that's happening. So, if you guys see it, holla at your boy, you know. But I think that's cool. I like that he probably came in through Rat's Nest. Did he say that he came in through Rat's Nest? I would love to know that.
If I remember correctly, but I can't say for sure, but the funniest thing is like, you know, Brent's like a...
Brent, message us.
Grateful Dead, fish guy, you know what I mean?
Dude.
That's a testament.
Brent looks like a guy that would like live by a creek for like a month just because he needed to figure shit out
100%.
For a little bit, you know what I mean? Like he just needed to chill and get some vibes going, you know what I mean? Like you would not think, oh, Rat's Nest, this guy's like, it's not like... Metallica or anything. I'm not trying to stereotype folks, whatever, but like he's not wearing a black and white band shirt that's like, what's up, dog?
No way,
like, showing
dude.
Up in boots. Nah, man, this guy's like, he looks like he had a fishing
pole. He has one band shirt and it's our King Gizzard shirt.
You know it, dog. He looks like he had a fishing pole. His backpack, he was like pulling out all of his shit. It looked like he was going to pull a fishing pole out and being like, yeah, dude, I just catched some rad fish. I cooked some earlier, dude. Like,
it's sick out here.
He looked like Colorado. He already looked like he lived here. It was very funny. He didn't look like he came from Florida. I don't think he is from Florida, but it looked like he was just here. But anyways, so yeah, you're right. The diversity of the band, the diversity of the audience, it all is. It's also something to be grateful for, because you get to meet new people, especially us. We get to meet new people, and you know,
so fun, damn it, that's so crazy, man.
And we get to put ourselves in positions to ask questions that give us more knowledge than the average bear about the Gizzverse, and like that. That was, I think, and I think the things we're most grateful for this year would be the meetups, the one incidental meetup and then the one on purpose meetup. Both of those were very successful, what I would say. And the only reason they were successful is because people that listen to this podcast, people that follow us on Instagram, people that participated in both events all helped put it all together and help people. And when I say put it together, I mean put together the community, if that makes sense. So,
yeah, dude, that's huge, man. Absolutely.
So we were tasked with, We started putting these together ourselves, and then people, the community, as we're interacting with them, came together. It just molded perfectly together. When we decided to do this, we didn't know it was going to be this big. We thought it was just going to be like, yeah, man, you know, it'd be cool. Man, if 100 people show up, that would be insane. Holy shit,
That'd be crazy,
and we were
man.
Just like, yeah, we'll do a podcast. It'll be tight, whatever. We'll sell some shirts. You know what I'm saying? Talk to people. Ask them questions about the Gizzverse. It'll be a good time. More and more people contacted us. More and more people reached out. More and more people wanted to be a part of the event. The Giz community just kind of grew. I've seen it. It's just like the community is becoming more developed even as a result of these, which is kind of great. And it was organic the way it developed. We're not taking credit like that, but it's just cool to see how, you know what I'm saying? Organically, how it's just kind of developed even more, even stronger, a community within a community. It's wild and could not be more grateful. And it's 100% because people fuck with us, fuck with people like Saigooties and all the other vendors and all the other people that participated just showing up. There was people just there to document it. You know what I mean? There was people there to just kind of just chill and be a part of it. You know, we had friends fly across the country for it. So it was a
madness. It was insane.
Really humbling experience. And then simultaneously to watch some of the craziest shows go on. It was wild. It was wild, man. Cool, grateful experience.
Truly is, man.
And you got to see him in Miami. And that's we usually tag each other back. You got a few ahead of me for sure, but like we're usually envious because you know you'll see stuff that I didn't see, and I'll see stuff that you didn't see, and stuff like that, which it happens.
Yeah, which makes sense, especially now we're like other sides of the country, so it definitely makes sense. Yeah. But it's I don't know, man. It is all damn cool. It's to me, it's crazy that Miami was the same year. I feel like that was forever ago at this point. You know what I mean? I was like, whoa, yeah, that was this year. So the fact that we could like squeeze in two of those, you know, and like be a part of those things is really neat, man. It just like opens up what the future could be. And like, it's fun, man. The fan base is only going to keep developing, and like these will come more organically. There will be some in places that we're not located in. And that's cool, man. Right. That's like so fun. It's like, yeah, man, it's like pretty wild. I think the idea of like making shirts and stuff like that is cool. We just love the community being supportive of it. And then seeing it out in the wild is just like, I mean, it's like, I don't know, dude. There's like my 12-year-old dream, and I didn't even, obviously I didn't know King Gizzard when I was 12, but like the idea of that maybe has always been in my psyche. You know, like, oh, dude, like being like following a banner. Sure, like we wish we could, I don't know, go see Gizzard a little more, this and that, but we've been fortunate to see them so much, man, you know?
Yeah.
And
we did it at
and
the
who knows writing. How many shows we'll see moving forward.
We did it at the right.
I really think so.
Yeah, financially we could afford it, and we were also simultaneously not tied down, weren't married at the time, like we're not, didn't have kids.
Right.
It's just like a perfect 5-year opportunity to just get fucking banged up and go check them out whenever they came to town. And that was the time that they were touring madness, and they were taking gigs that they're,
dude.
If you saw the shit that they were playing in back in the day, you'd be like, what? And it's like, yeah, dude, they were playing some tiny holes in the wall that were madness. Brian told me about seeing them in Washington, and I was just, I'm envious of that show. I didn't get to see him because that sounded like a hole in the wall and just, it was madness.
Rock hard.
It was madness. And that's what, that's again, if you heard me criticize the Red Rocks venue, that's kind of why I was criticized, because it's just a completely different vibe, you know, completely different. So
different.
So let me ask you this. Christmas is coming up. The holidays are coming up. Besides making sure to get your pre-orders in for the Gizzverse podcast coasters and the Gizzverse podcast t-shirt that's coming out for next year's tour, I love when bands used to do Christmas songs. I know that sounds cheesy. Mm. Maybe people don't like Christmas as much as I like Christmas, and that's okay, because it's not cool to like Christmas anymore. Because some people think it's like strictly religious and stuff like that. So I don't give a I like it. I like the decorations. I'll believe Santa's real. I don't care. I don't know about
the day I'm dead.
The religious aspect has nothing to do with me. I don't care. I know a lot, whatever. You could give me some historical reason why I should feel bad about liking Santa, but like, okay, maybe you're right. Maybe you're right. You're probably right. Hitler liked Santa too. I'm sure Hitler liked Santa at some point. Hitler probably got some Christmas points.
Son of a bitch.
That bastard. You know what I mean? But like, there's nothing I can do about it. I like the colors. I like the trees. I like it all. King Gizzard's my favorite band on the planet. I think this is a well-known thing, all right? At this point. Now, you're saying, okay, Tommy, AC/DC was your favorite band for so long. Yes.
It's all intertwined, buddy.
And this is, Brian understands this. Brian understands this, so I don't have to explain this any further. Anyways, what songs, holiday songs, Christmas songs, whatever songs, could be whatever winter holiday you want to give me. I don't care. Let us know in the comments section, too, because that's why I mentioned that. Whatever holiday song. Do you think King Gizzard should cover and release? What Christmas song should King Gizzard
and
do?
Release, boy,
And release. They could do it as a gag, like as a total gag, just for fun. Because, dude, they do stuff for fun. They're funny guys. They're not just out here dead serious. They're not taking them, especially seeing them at Red Rocks. They don't take themselves dead serious. I saw, like, sound malfunctions happen, and they were just like, you know, bullshitting, talking to the sound guy.
Sammy,
yeah,
turn
dude.
It
so like,
up.
They're funny dudes. They're funny guys. We all follow them on Instagram. So if they came out with maybe just like an acoustic riff, somebody was filming them and they were a little mic'd up. Maybe they were mic'd up. Acoustic riff, mic'd up. What Christmas song do you want to hear from them, or holiday song do you want to hear from them? Puerto Rican holiday song.
That opened up another world. But hold on, let me get this out, because I have two. I hate to say it, but let me start.
Yeah, I knew you did.
Realistically, I want to see them in like they're doing like a Mind Fuzz thing. You know, in Mind Fuzz, they have I think it's I'm Not in Your Mind. They do the bam, 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 bam.
Yes.
Okay. Right. Which like I can't tell you what that's called or where it's from, but
we've
all heard it a million times, right?
It's universal.
Universal sound, right? And they don't do a lot of like. I mean, I'm not saying that's a cover, but you know what I'm saying. They don't do a lot of noise like that, right?
Sure. Yeah.
You know what I mean? If they were doing a Christmas show and start doing a bang, 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 and then just tying that back to like a robot stop or something, yo, that the it would be bananas, my man, bananas. It would be little.
Yes. I knew I wrote this question down for a reason. Yes. Okay. Do you have another one? I just loved your impression of them playing a Christmas song. I wasn't expecting that to be so on point. That was because it even sounds like Head on Pill. You know what I mean? A little bit the way you did it.
Yeah.
It's very funny.
If they were playing Head on Pill, they're doing that. You know, they do that shit for like 20 minutes sometimes. If they just jump into that for like a minute, everybody's like, yo, what the fuck? Oh, dude, that would be. Yeah, that would be awesome. That would be awesome. You got Ambrose with a little jingle bell or something. Yo, that'd be a vibe. It would be a vibe. So that's my realistic, amazing one. Do you know, and I hope you do, because you're a big Christmas guy. It came on the other day, and Emily's sisters did not know this song, and I was like, what? Do you know Britney Spears' Christmas song?
No. Maybe if I heard it, I would know it, but I don't know it just by the description of Britney Spears' Christmas song, but I don't know the artist a lot of times. That's my fault. I really do.
Fair.
Don't.
Okay,
so,
fair.
Like, I'm not an artist. But
I'll sing you a little ditty.
I was going to say, could you sing it for me a little bit? I know that's a lot.
All I want just for me underneath my Christmas tree.
100%.
I'll be waiting there. Santa, you're my only wish this year.
That's Britney Spears?
Britney fucking Spears, dog.
Yo,
isn't that crazy?
Awesome. Good for her. No, I know that tune. I've heard it a million times. I just jammed.
I like that one a bunch.
I'm that guy. I jammed to the Christmas channel. Sorry. I know. I suck during Christmas. I really suck. But
Britney Spears, dog.
Call yourself a Giz fan, you fool. Listen to Mariah Carey and Britney Spears. I did not know that was Britney Spears, but that's awesome. I think Britney Spears is like a mega talent. I think she's killing it. But yeah, they didn't know it was her.
No, and I mean, you know, like they grew up, like, dude, they know some Britney Spears, right? You know what I mean? Like,
right.
So they were like, Michelle, his youngest sister, was like, "How do you know this?" I was like, "Well, the reason I know this is because it played at Marshall's when I worked there for a while."
Oh,
like,
right.
You know, the holidays religiously, and I was like, "This is Britney, huh?" like, this, it's my favorite Christmas song, easily.
Hey, all right, nice.
Yeah.
So you low-key want to hear them play Britney Spears' Christmas song is what you're trying to tell me right now?
Hot take, you heard it here first. And I want Cookie singing that shit. Or I don't care, anybody can sing it. You know what I mean? But I want that shit to be weird.
Weird. Okay, so you want it to be a weird one.
Weird.
I was going to ask, what flavor are we talking? What Giz flavor? Because you said cook dog, so that's a unique taste.
Weird.
For the cook dog.
Yeah, super, yeah, for sure. Yeah, I know. It's got to be weird with it. You heard Slipknot does a cover of Livin' La Vida Loca?
No, but that's probably really good.
It's the way Ricky Martin does it. It's like, it's not like a metal version. You know, they have a full, big old band, you know?
Yeah.
So, I mean, YouTube, if you get to, it's like he's singing it like Ricky. It's not like, you're not like, oh my God, it's a Slipknot? You don't know. You know what I mean?
Right.
It's like, it's pretty entertaining.
Right. That's hilarious. I like when bands do that. I'm a fan. I'm okay with that. Now, I might not be a fan if King Gizzard does it, but if they just jam
Same,
a little
me
bit,
too.
You know what I mean? Because I want to see their songs. They're putting out new albums. They're putting out new heat. I'm not trying to see. But if you've seen Slipknot 100 times and they haven't put out an album for the last 4 years, it's like, yeah, okay, play some Ricky Martin. I'm down. Okay. I like your answers.
Thank you, buddy.
Yeah.
I'm dying to know yours for the record.
Wow, man. I did not know yours were going to be that good. And yours came with an impression. I don't know that I'm going to
We did not talk about this.
Do an impression of it. Yeah, but I didn't know your impression was going to be that good. I didn't know. I'm going to fall short here. But Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer was going to be my pick. And I don't... Ooh. If I was going to pick a style, I would say... microtonal flying banana would be the so some microtonal stuff.
I kind of saw that too for whatever reason.
Doing it in a little off key or whatever, or not like not the right key, I think would sound if you didn't like notice what it was at first, and then like minimal lyrics, and then a cool like drum solo in the middle of it or something like that. Bro, I can't do an impression of what I want it to be in my head. You know what I mean? Because that's not my. I can't. That's them. They're good at that. If I could sit in a room with Stu, I know he could do it in 2 seconds, which is the craziest.
Done and done, brother.
Dude, these guys are nuts. I know it would be so funny to do that. And I don't want to play.
You said microtonal?
They're not monkeys. You know what I mean? You can't do that. But if I just send him a description like that, he'd be like, okay. All right. Nope. No problem, man.
Here we go.
Listen to Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Maybe. He probably wouldn't even need to do that. He probably just has it in his head because he's a savant.
We've all heard it, you know.
Boom, dude. So Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, like a instrumental up front, and then get into it. And I think it would be fun. I'm sorry I don't have an impression like Brian, guys. He buried me.
No, that's fine. That's fine.
I should have went first. I didn't know Brian was going to bury me. All right? I got toasted on that one, guys. Toasted. Dirt flat.
Well, no, but let me ask you something, man. Are you going, where are we going tempo-wise? You thinking same speed? We going slower?
Slower. That's the thing about the microtonal is, like, I think it would be cooler slower, and then they could speed it up on the solo. So, like, I think, like, in the solo, they could change the tempo a little bit and kind of finish off... When, like, Rudolph triumphants and goes, like, they're making fun of him up front, you know what I mean? But then Rudolph triumphantly starts, so, like, as Rudolph goes out and he's, like, helping Santa and shit, then the solo kicks off and then they come down and then, like, Rudolph saved the day and now everyone's like, yeah, fuck yeah, Rudolph, you're the fucking man, Rudolph. And then you can play a little visual in the background. I'm sorry, guys. I know this is really cheesy, but like that is exactly that would be so fucking epic if they for like a 5 minute flat like thing jam session on it, and they could just like rip because they're them, so they could just fucking and just rip it, dude. And then make like it's like a snowstorm vibe, you know what I mean? Like it's like tumultuous,
oh, for sure.
You know what I mean? That's what the solo is about. The solo is all about that shit. Yeah.
Listen, man, I like where this is going now. When you first said Rudolph, I was like, eh,
thanks
okay,
for asking the question,
sure.
No, I needed the question. You needed to throw out the question.
Yeah, I got you, buddy. I got you.
For sure.
Now, okay, I'm chewing on it more. And like, while I agree with you, I think it'd be a good one. Man, it's so cliche of me at this point, but let me tell you my vision on it now, okay?
Okay.
Because now I'm kind of seeing, I hate to bring it up again, I'm kind of seeing Coop Dog singing this, okay?
Okay.
And it's getting a little weird. And I'm thinking the tempo can stay.
A little weird.
It's getting a little weird. The tempo, I think, can stay similar.
Okay.
With the Cookie vocals, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Ooh. I think it sounded really funny.
See, this is what I needed. I needed some true vision and impression on this. But yeah, no, that actually sounded really good.
It has like a weird, like kind of like a garden gobbly, like jump vibe. And then you got Ambi in the background. Rudolph! And they're jamming. And Joey's just in there, just blah, 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 plucking, you know, Stu, him and Stu going back at it, dude. You know what I mean? Cook is up on keys doing vocals.
Yes.
Yeah, dude. That's kind of where I'm at with it. You know what I mean? Where you at with this?
No, I love it. And it's getting weird. I like the vision. I'm gonna need to see both on paper and played in front of me, and then I can vote on them. You know what I mean? But like,
fair.
You brought it all together. I'm gonna be honest, and I appreciate that. It needed a little sauce on the end. So it's good.
We're here, buddy.
Good analysis on that one, Brian. You know what I mean?
King Gizzard needs to get at us for this stuff, man. We could be, you know, I mean, Jason Galea is now the seventh. We could be the eighth and ninth members. You know what I mean, guys? We're open.
They just have to ask us, and they don't even have to ask us. We'll just be there if they don't even need us for anything.
Make an Instagram story, and we see it, we're there.
Something that we've talked about in the past, King Gizzard toys for the holidays. Are they? I've seen people make them by themselves. Is there somebody out there that's doing this? Is this something that we should jump on?
There is somebody that's doing this, and let me shout out this motherfucker right here, right now.
For sure.
You probably can't get one because it's sold out. But it's our good buddy 10 Yards. I don't know. If you haven't seen him, man, I must send you the link absolutely immediately. He made an actual Lego, like, with a box. I mean, they're actual Legos. It comes with an instruction manual on how to make the... I'm trying to, like, save it up to what it is. He made a little Hamtayumi robot. It is perfect. It is amazing. It is super cool. He made... these are like 10 of them. They sold out immediately. He made a few more. They're very cool, dude. You are a toy guy. I don't know if we haven't talked about it before. You're a toy guy?
Yeah.
This would be a sick thing to have in the collection, dude. It's like all like, I mean, it's boxed up perfect. Awesome. Awesome.
I'll definitely, I know I've seen some pictures, some posts of it. I'll definitely take a look at it. I think that's a hilarious thing and a worthy investment. I know that sounds silly to people, but not to me. That sounds hilarious. And then this is what I really think is something that's useful is, maybe I should talk about this off the air, but like making toys of the characters from the Gizzverse, a Lord of Lightning, a Belrog. So like having stuff within the lore. So maybe we'll talk about that off the air. So I don't know if you guys know this or not, but there's a little CC at the end of every podcast. And if you guys steal anything from us, we come at you with the fury of lawyers. I'm just kidding.
Hard.
But that sounds like a good
strong
idea.
Ones.
That might strong ones. Giz related ones. They like King Gizzard just as much as we do, pal. Okay. And they're pissed.
They're pissed.
While we're talking about getting pissed. I don't know if we've talked about this or not too much, but let me ask you, are you wanting to do a giveaway this year to people? Do you want to do that?
A giz-away, you mean?
A giz-away? I'll edit this out. If you say no, I'll edit this out right now.
And it never happened.
And it never happened.
This doesn't exist.
No one's got to know.
You know what? Yeah. Okay. I could be very okay with that. I think somebody, I think we should do like one of those, hey, man, listen, man, you got to like, subscribe, you know, tell your buddies, right. Share with 42 different lost souls, and you might go, I think we should do that, absolutely.
So we don't want to, we'll figure out exactly how to do it, because we'll set like the, I don't know what platform or what parameters or whatever, but it's going to be tough for us to keep track of all of it, to be honest with you, and we want to get everyone in the, you know, make sure we pick the right person and all that stuff, not some bot hacker, you know what I'm saying, Doug?
No, for sure. But with our very cool little following we have, we'll figure it out. And I know there's also an app that you can put in like all the names, and it like it does like a totally random, you know, so there's no like,
don't worry, guys.
No, I mean, we could just put them in a hat, whatever, but there's no funny business.
We'll pick a super hot girl with a lot of followers and we'll just give it to her, just like she gets everything else for free, all right? No problem. We got you covered. Fuck
the winner is Jennifer Aniston.
Fuck that.
Well, yeah.
We are picking some guy that lives in his parents' basement still. That's who we're going with. He is going to, who's got 3 followers on Instagram, baby. That's our fucking guy.
And we're
He's winning. Big time this year, baby. Big time. Merry Gizmas, motherfucker. So Brian's right. We do have a lot of stuff. So we've collected some cool stuff over the years that I might have duplicates of that I may be willing to part with on top of some of our stuff. We'll see. Wink, wink. I don't know. I'm not going to guarantee what may or may not be inside of it. There's no way of really knowing what could be directly inside
of it. You never know.
We really don't know. It might be an ornament. It might be a coaster. It could be a t-shirt.
Bag of cookies.
Cookies? I'm not shipping cookies to you guys. That's fucked up. Who knows? I would never do that. I don't trust people. You know what I mean? Like that even...
You hear me?
We're not doing that. I barely trust the waiter, and the only reason I trust him is like he most likely doesn't want to lose his job. But then there's those people. But isn't that a waitress? Are we not calling that anymore? I don't know. But then there's those people who are just like that. I don't give a fuck mode. Like, I'm about to be evicted. I don't make enough money. My parents hate me. Fuck this world. And they will do anything to your plate. Like, just say, look at them wrong. And they'll just fucking do anything because they don't care anymore. So I do try to – I barely trust people to do it. I'm not cooking you guys cookies, in other words, all right? But we're going to – we'll do a giveaway. We'll talk about it the next 2 weeks – mostly these next couple days. It's going to be really interesting on Instagram. So make sure you guys are following us at Gizzverse Podcast. Stay up to date. Our stories are going to be where you find something direct if it's not in your feed. Make sure to go to Spotify. Or YouTube. Those are the two places that give us advertisement money and help us out. They haven't given us any yet. We're still waiting on it. But
not yet, but
eventually,
you know,
they will.
We're working.
We're working on it. So you guys keep going to those platforms, and we really appreciate that. Brian. Before we go, is there anything else you want to talk about? Mention any hot topics, any news, or anything like that?
Not at all, man. I feel really cozy about this one today. Felt nice, felt real, felt organic, felt deep, felt thankful. You know, I think we leave it here, man. I think everything you said, you know, come to the side. Make sure to pre-order those shirts and whatnot soon. More on the coasters coming very soon also. Let's take some cool pictures of those, man. We'll post a little something about that. They're very neat. I'm really excited about that. Really, really happy you're doing that. I'm very proud of what you're doing over there, man. I think it's fuck. You sent me a picture. I don't know why my instinct is to laugh because I think it's so cool. I'm just like, that's crazy. So
yeah,
I think it's very cool, and I think like you're only gonna get better at doing them. So I'm rambling, but I'm excited. That's all I gotta say about that.
I'm excited too. It was really hard to do it. I'm not gonna lie to you. I thought it originally.
I believe you 100%.
I was like, yeah, man, it's a good idea. You know, I'm like not wasting it because there's some stuff I want to burn for firewood. But then I was like, yeah, no, I'm not. This is a good way to, you know, keep it. It's like organic, not recycling, but it's like, you know, an organic use of art and all that. Anyways, and then
yeah, dude, for sure.
I was like, this shit is fucking hard as fuck, man. What the fuck, dude? It was super hard, dude.
It's a mistake.
Everyone has taken me a long time, so it's pushing me to the next one to get. It's mostly the stencil work. Getting the initial stencil perfect is really difficult, and then working from there is not as difficult. But I'm excited about it too, and I'm excited to share it with, you know, the Gizzverse and put it out there. This is the first time we've really talked about it, and the first time we've showed it. I'll do a little Christmas photo shoot with them.
Yeah, please do, for real though.
I'm gonna do some with the shirts as well because we do have some Red Rock shirts left available. I don't know how many specifically, but I think we have more than 10, so I think we're comfortable with selling a few more. We do want to bring some to the events so we can kind of have more than one shirt at the events.
But swag, swag.
We've been selling out, and you guys have been helping us do that, and we couldn't be more grateful. So we're not going to bitch about selling out. So that's not going to be something we're going to do with the Gizzverse Podcast, guys.
No, sir.
We'll do one more podcast before the end of the year. So we'll do a little New Year's Giz podcast talking about the what's to come. You know, what some goals for us personally, some goals for the podcast and all that fun stuff. Thank you guys again for being a part of this show and being part of the Gizzverse. We're probably not going to talk to you before Christmas. We might, and if so, who cares? Because I'm wishing you Merry Christmas twice, and that's always a good thing. So, Merry,
that's nice.
Merry Christmas, Merry Gizmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Kwanzaa, Happy all those other holidays that I don't know anything about, and that's cool too, bro, because
Santa
weirdly exists in every single holiday. I know you don't feel like it, but he's around. And if you're looking for a movie to go see this year, go see Violent Night. That's an incredible fucking movie. It's a new movie that just came out in theaters. The guy from Stranger Things in it. It's fucking incredible. Go see that movie. It's amazing. Brian,
I don't even care.
Say Merry Christmas to everybody, buddy.
Merry Christmas to you. Merry Gizmas to your souls. The universe has an invisible face, but we do not. Look at our happy faces, you guys. Happy holidays to you and you and all of yours. Keep gizzing till the sun comes up or goes back down, baby.
Yeah.
We back
fuck
at it.
Fuck yeah. And if we don't talk to you guys, have a good holiday. We love you. I don't care if that's weird. I don't care if I've never met you before.
It's not weird. I don't
it's
care.
It's not weird, man. There's a lot of you. So what? A lot of you guys we did meet, and we're like, wow, this is a mind blow. Some of you guys have been with us since the inception. Yeah,
brain.
Dude. I don't want to cry, but fucking Merry Christmas, bro.
I gotta go.
We'll
man.
Talk to you soon.
Shut it down. Shut
we'll
it down.
Talk to you guys soon. Thank you.
See
so
you,
much.
Buddy. Shut it down.
Peace.